The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents...
Since time began, man has been fascinated by the unknown. The word fascinate tells us that, because its real meaning is to bewitch, to hold spellbound. Our stories explore both the known and the unknown, about persons held prisoner by the quirks of their minds. They become the outcasts. Most of us dismiss as mental illness their stories of being devil-possessed, of encountering ghouls, or of foreseeing the future. But can we ignore a person, clinically dead, miraculously restored to life? In the village of Perryville, a farming community in western Massachusetts, Father Francis puts down his coffee mug.
Excellent coffee, Sarah. Thank you for it, and for your contribution to the discretionary fund.
Oh, you're welcome, Father, I'm sure. Ours is a poor parish, and those who can should help. Thanks to Kim, the herd produces in abundance.
What's her secret?
Well, she has a way with animals. It's a gift, you might say. With her college education and all, I never expected her to return to the farm, but when Zeb died... back she came from Boston.
She's content?
Unfulfilled. Kim is 27 and alone.
Our mystery story, The Force of Evil, was written especially for Mystery Theater by Roy Windsor. It stars Paul Hecht and Diane Kirkwood. I will return shortly with Act One. Very few of us can deny the fascination of the mysterious. It does hold us spellbound. Superstitions that won't die. The permutations of astrology that suggest the heavens are interested in individual destiny. And phenomena that cannot be explained. We have finite minds, unable to penetrate the infinite. It is one of the phenomena we now explore. Standing in the cave, a handsome 28-year-old farmer has bought milk and eggs from the Paris dairy farm since he was a boy. He has just driven up to the old farmhouse and enters Sarah Paris' parlor.
Morning, Sarah. Sarah.
Hello? Oh, Stan. Well, come for your milk and eggs?
Yeah, and something else. Where's Kim?
In the cow barn, supervising the milking.
Oh, can Carl and Ed handle that?
Oh, of course. They're old hands at it. But you know Kim.
Yeah, I ought to. We grew up together. Well, I'll walk down and see her.
You said you came for something else?
Yeah. I'm engaged to marry Lucy Trumbull.
No.
Hey, what kind of reaction is that? I'm not so bad, sir.
Oh, no, no. No, that's not what I meant. My goodness, you're handsome and you're a good farmer, Stan. Very good. No. What I meant was... Lucy Trumbull? That's stepping up in the world.
Sure is.
Mr. Trumbull's worth a mint.
And owns a mint. The farmer's bank.
Well, I'm happy for you, Stan. And the Trumbulls are a fine family. I just can't get over it.
Yeah, neither can I, Sarah. Just dumb luck, I guess. I'm crazy about Lucy, and, well, I guess she likes me.
Well, I wish you happiness, Stan. And Lucy, of course.
Thanks.
You'll... sell your farm.
Oh, no, no, no.
But the Trumbull farm will be Lucy's one day.
Yeah, I suppose so, but after we're married, we'll live in my house and I'll farm my land. I'm marrying Lucy.
Her family isn't going to absorb me, Sarah. Well, I want to see Kim and pick up the milk.
Dan, I'm going to ask a favor. Let me break the news to Kim.
But Kim is my best friend.
Please, Dan.
You don't want me to tell her?
Just let me. Best friend or not, this will be a surprise to her, as it was to me.
Well, of course it will be a surprise.
But maybe not all that joyous a surprise.
Hi, Mother. Hey, anything the matter?
No. I've come for Stan's milk and eggs.
Is something the matter with him?
No, he's fine.
He sent you for the milk and eggs? He's never done.
Well, it was my idea, Kim. He wanted to see you, but I said, let me break the news.
Well?
You've been good friends since you were children.
He's my best friend. I love him.
Of course, dear. As a friend. And just that. Nothing more, or more would have come of it.
Don't hedge, Mother. Is he leaving Perryville? Selling out?
No.
Well?
Kim, he's engaged to marry Lucy Trumbull.
Oh. I see. And, he came to tell you?
To tell us, Kim. I thought it better that I told you.
Well.
You can still be friends, Kim?
Of course.
I know it hurts. It hurts me.
Why should it? We've been going together ever since I returned from Boston. As the newspapers might report, we were an item. Walked to church together. Went to dances together. Fishing. Range meetings. Suppers here and at his house. Like a brother and sister. Right?
Don't be bitter, Kim.
Lucy Trumbull. A porcelain doll. A piece of bric-a-brac. Skis in Colorado and winters at a pool in Arizona. Well, he's welcome to her. Won't she make a wonderful farmer's wife, Mother?
Kim, please.
Oh, don't please me.
I must. Now face it. Did Stan ever ask you to marry him?
Not in so many words, no.
Then you have to accept the fact that he's in love with Lucy Trumbull.
He's in love with her money. Stan must have more common sense than to be bewitched by that vapid, simpering nothing. He can't possibly love her. He loves me. He respects me.
Everyone respects you, Kim. You're a remarkable young woman, and I am very proud of you.
He won't have her.
Kim, don't say that.
I mean it. Stan McCabe isn't going to marry Lucy Trumbull. I won't have it.
Hi, Lucy.
Stan, you're positively glowing.
You know, Lucy, I just can't believe my luck.
I didn't expect to see you, Stan. I thought you were driving to Amherst.
Well, I'm on my way. I picked up our milk and eggs and told Sarah about us.
Oh?
Yeah, she wished us happiness.
And Kim?
Well, Sarah wanted to tell Kim herself.
Of course.
Of course? Why, of course?
You don't know.
Well, what's there to know, sweetheart? Kim's my best friend. I wanted to tell her myself.
I don't believe it. You still think of Kim as a best friend. Don't you know she's always been in love with you?
No, I don't believe it.
Well, it's true. Everyone knows it. Or has known it. Except you.
But I don't love Kim in that way, Lucy. You're the one I love.
Well, that makes me glow because I love you. But you've broken Kim's heart. Mrs. Parris knew that, and that's why she wanted to tell Kim instead of you telling her.
Well, I do my own thinking and feeling. What everyone else might think, my feelings are my own. And they're yours.
Are you sure?
Oh, come on, Lucy. Don't tell me you're not sure about how I feel about you.
I guess not.
Oh, well, there's a great answer. Well, I guess I'll be on my way.
Now you're angry.
Well, what, am I supposed to be happy? I ask you to marry me, and you and everyone else thinks Kim is in love with me, and I'm supposed to be in love with her. Mrs. Paris wants to break the news to Kim, and then Mrs. Paris wonders how my mother and you will get along in my house.
Stan.
The next thing you'll tell me everyone, including your parents, thinks I'm marrying you because of the Trumbull money. Well, I wish everyone would mind their own business.
I didn't mean to get you upset, Stan.
Well, I am upset. Well, look, I better go. Right now, I just want to be by myself.
Kim?
Come in, Mother. What is it?
Are you all right?
Of course I'm all right.
Kim, I wish I could do something. Maybe you should have a talk with Father Francis. He knows the ways of the heart.
He knows the ways of the church. Nothing more. Can he change what's happened, Mother?
He can bring you comfort.
Oh, words. Just words.
Oh, child, don't say that. Our faith is what sustains us. Cling to faith and it will protect you and give you strength.
Strength for what? To accept Stan's engagement? It would be just like that simple Lucy Trumbull to ask me to be a bridesmaid. Well, I won't have it. I said that earlier and I mean it.
Kim, don't talk nonsense. There's nothing you can do about it.
I think there is.
Please, for my sake.
Oh, don't worry, Mother. No harm will come to you. Oh, Stan, didn't you know? When we were 15, wasn't it understood? When we were away at college, wasn't the feeling there in our letters? Didn't I return from Boston when my father died because of my love for you?
And now he is infatuated with a young woman who is only a pretty, empty face.
How can it be?
You have had questions before, and we have gone over them. I am your subconscious. I am able to expose hypocrisy wherever I find it. That has been a trait of your father's family for centuries. With it comes a power that sets you apart from others. Has it not given you your way with animals? With plants?
I've tried to resist the trait. You are more than my subconscious. I have always known that unless I resisted that trait, I could become a disciple of the devil.
Can you deny his everlasting presence? Mankind has two faces. One he shows to others, and one he shows only to himself. The latter is his subconscious. In that dark side of the mind, men and women know the truth. Bind yourself to me, and you will have the power to work miracles.
Bind myself to what? My subconscious?
To those of us who work to enlist souls in the name of the fallen angel.
Become a disciple of Lucifer?
Many women in your heritage have been such disciples. In Salem, they were tortured and put to death. Do not resist your gift. Satan's power is mighty, and those who follow him are mighty in their work.
Well, I have the power to prevent this marriage?
You will demonstrate your power immediately. When you awaken in the morning, you will effect a cure which will mystify your local doctor, confound the priest, and make Stanley McCabe wonder. Our powers are real. Go to sleep. You are committed. You have made your choice. You have fulfilled the obligations to your heritage. Sleep well, sister.
Just what have we here? A pact with the devil? Our theme seems to be witchcraft. Do not regard the subject lightly. It still exists. As recently as 1970, a woman in Arizona was suspended from her job for teaching witchcraft. In Lisbon, Portugal, a boy was told to have an operation to save his legs. His parents consulted a witch, and the operation did not have to be performed. More when I return with Act Two shortly. We may no longer accept those figures of the devil with his long tail and huge bat-like wings. But belief in the devil and his witches still persists in the deep recesses of our subconscious. Luther's writings are filled with tales of his painful battles with supernatural friends. What is the trait that Kim has inherited? And that mention of Salem. Late in the afternoon the next day, Stanley McCabe is having tea with Father Francis Sims.
Stanley, like it or not, Lucy was right. Kim has always been in love with you. Are you really so obtuse you haven't known that?
Yes, but there are different kinds of love. I mean, Kim's about the finest young woman I've ever known. I love her for what she is, but I never thought about marrying her.
Why not?
Well, I don't know. She's always sort of, stood apart. We've always done things together, but it's been, like buddies. I never thought of Kim as
a woman.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
Hmm. And then you found Lucy Trumbull.
That's right, and I fell in love with her.
Can you understand how Kim must feel now? Be honest with yourself.
Well, what can I do about it?
Nothing, I'm afraid. You should have warned her off long ago. Now you've made an enemy.
Kim? An enemy?
I think so. Lucy sensed it, and so do I. Have you heard what happened to Johnny Gilbert?
He didn't die.
No. He's been cured.
What? Johnny cured? But Doc Rutledge has been treating him for some kind of lesions for a long time. Lupus something.
Yes, lupus erythematosus. It's usually a fatal systemic disease. Johnny has suffered severely, as you know.
Well, I thought it would be a blessing if he died. But you say he's cured?
So Dr. Rutledge told me.
The disease retrogressed suddenly?
Not at all. It disappeared in a day.
Well, how does the doctor explain it?
He can't.
Then it's a miracle.
It is, indeed. And that's what disturbs me. Kim Paris cured the boy.
Kim? How?
Early this morning, she visited Johnny. Kim told Mrs. Gilbert to go to our church and take a blessed church candle, melt it, and cover Johnny's body with it. Mrs. Gilbert thought Kim was mad, but she was so desperate, she did what Kim advised.
But that's witchcraft.
The fact remains, Johnny Gilbert has been cured.
Yes, but it's blasphemy.
So it seems to me.
No.
Now, calm down. Go softly. And listen to me, Stanley. Kim has always been pretty much alone. She does, as you said, stand apart. She is a superior woman. Can you explain why she has that gift with animals, with all God's creatures, great and small?
No, I can't.
Well, then consider this. Has Kim Paris made a pact with the devil?
Oh, that's absurd. The devil in this day?
I've been giving it a lot of thought, Stan. And I've thought a lot about Kim.
Why? Why, because of her gift?
Oh, I've gone back further than that, Stanley. Her name.
Oh, you've lost me.
Paris. Does that mean anything to you?
No. Well, that's a nice name, huh? Paris with two R's.
Well, back in 1692, there was living in Salem, Massachusetts, a West Indian slave named Tituba. Mr. Paris was a parson, and Tituba used to amuse Elizabeth Paris and her cousin Abigail with tricks and tales of the occult.
And Kim is a descendant of that family.
Yes. When Reverend Paris discovered what Tituba had been doing, the girls all named Tituba as the witch who had been tormenting them. And the Salem witch hunt was on. By the time it ended, 7 men and 13 women had been executed.
No, but Tituba was the witch and not Elizabeth Paris.
That's right. But Elizabeth was an impressionable 9-year-old. Do you think that what Tituba did and said had no effect on the child? Oh, that Elizabeth didn't pass on to her children what she had learned and perhaps had begun to believe. The mystery and the appeal of the occult became part of the Paris heritage.
Well, that's stretching it pretty far, Father. To suspect Kim of being in league with the devil, to regard her as a witch?
Kim, will you get that, please?
All right, Mother.
Hello, Kim.
Father.
Now, I know it's supper time.
Oh, that's all right. Come in. It's Father Francis.
Well, I'll be right in.
May I serve you something? A cup of tea? Wine?
No. Thank you. I'm staying only a few minutes. How are you, Kim?
I'm well, thank you.
Well, how nice of you to drop in, Father Francis. How are you?
Fine, just fine. I won't interrupt your supper.
It's ready to be served at any time. Will you stay and eat with us?
Another time, thank you. You're wondering why I dropped in without warning, so I'd better tell you. Kim, you've got Dr. Rutledge and the village turned topsy-turvy.
Kim has?
You don't know, Sarah?
I'll tell you, Mother. I made a sick call this morning on Johnny Gilbert.
Oh, that poor, poor boy.
Oh, no longer, Sarah. He's been cured.
Cured? I suggested to Johnny's mother that she take a blessed candle from the church and melt it and apply the tallow to Johnny's lesions. She did. It worked. Mrs. Gilbert came to me in the cherry orchard and told me so. She fell to her knees.
But... Well, it's a miracle.
That's exactly what Stan said when I told him.
But, Kim, how? I mean, you performed a miracle?
And it was that. How did you accomplish it, Kim? How did you know the cure to suggest?
It simply came to me. Johnny's cured. Isn't that enough?
Oh, but people will want to know. We'll have to tell them something.
Then tell them that there are forces in this universe beyond their simple comprehensions.
But not yours. Is that it, Kim?
To answer yes would be presumptuous, Father.
Since the world was created, good and evil have been opposing forces. The struggle for the souls of men and women is everlasting. God on the one hand, the devil on the other.
The devil? Father, we don't believe in a literal devil.
Kim, has he possessed your soul?
Father, how dare you?
It's all right, Mother. Father Francis is the shepherd of your flock, and he's concerned about a stray. That's all.
You think of yourself as a stray?
But don't you think so, Mother? The fields and the animals are my life. I have no friends. The future holds nothing for me, Mother. You see that, don't you?
No need to prolong this, Sarah. I have my answer.
I'll check on the supper, Mother.
Kim, say goodnight to Father Francis.
May heaven protect you, Sarah, and may he save your daughter.
You frighten me, Father.
Stan, stop pacing. Please, sit down. Here. Next to me, please.
All right. You're not concerned, Lucy?
No, I don't believe any part of it. Kim, a witch? Say the word and ask yourself if you believe it.
What about Johnny Gilbert?
Who knows? Kim's a member of the church. She got an idea that something from the church, a blessed candle, might have some power to help the boy. That's all. It did.
Yeah, but medically it makes no sense.
Who cares? Stan, I'm tired of talking about Kim. Let's drop it. Forget about her. Is that clear?
Yeah, sure is.
I hope so. You proposed to me, and we're going to be married, I think.
Well, of course we're going to be married.
Then let's think about that, sweetheart. We meet, and what do we talk about? Kim and her gift with animals. Kim and you as old fishing buddies. Kim, the intellectual, and now Kim, as of all things, a witch. I don't want to hear any more about your former girlfriend.
Oh, now, please, Lucy.
I mean it. Get her out of your system. I'm sick of the subject. When you do, come back. I'll be here, and maybe we'll pick up where we left off.
I saw the light in the church, Father. I wanted to talk with you.
Yes, I came here to pray for the salvation of the soul of Kim Paris. I also prayed for guidance. Stanley, it was a mistake for you not to tell Kim about becoming engaged to Lucy Trumbull.
Yes, but Father, I intended to, but... Well, Sarah asked me to let her tell Kim. Was that a mistake?
If you'd taken Kim in your arms, and if she had forced herself to congratulate you, perhaps, even though her heart was breaking, she might have put aside any thoughts of revenge.
Well, what can she do, Father? She's not crazy. She wouldn't harm me physically.
I don't know what she might do. But what she did for Johnny Gilbert is an indication of a power she now possesses.
You really believe this witch nonsense?
It's not nonsense, Stan.
Well, Lucy thinks it is. I just left her. Rather, she tossed me out. Lucy's fed up with my preoccupation with Kim.
Well, can't you understand that?
Sure, sort of, but... Well, if my engagement has shaken Kim badly, I feel that I have to stand by her. I can't abandon her now.
Stan, the devil has possessed her soul. That's why I came here to pray.
Well, what can I do, Father? I want this settled, and I want my life to return to normal.
See her and talk with her. Tell her the kind of love you bear her. Help her to accept your decision. Maybe it's not too late to save her from herself.
Kim, where are you going? It's almost bedtime.
For a walk.
Kim... Will you tell me the truth about Johnny Gilbert?
I have nothing to tell.
The priest thinks you've entered into a pact with the devil.
He's a simple-minded old man, Mother.
When I told you about the engagement, you said that Lucy will never have him. Do you still say that?
He will never have Lucy.
You will prevent the marriage?
Yes.
What will you have gained?
Satisfaction.
3 broken hearts instead of 1?
Mine will be healed.
And in exchange for this, you have entered into a vile pact with the forces of evil? Then let me tell you something, Kim. If you have brought the power of evil into our old farmhouse, I will excommunicate you. As much as I have loved you, as much as I know how badly you have been hurt, I won't have you here.
In medieval times, the devil was a real and active enemy who was blamed for mishaps or disasters. The devil was interested in all men, and like the gods of ancient myth, he continually interfered in human affairs. To Martin Luther and his contemporaries, the devil's greatest threat was his determination to capture human souls. That is what Father Francis fears for Kim Paris. He is convinced that she is a witch. We'll find out when I return with Act 3 shortly. When most of us think about witches, we picture an old hag in a pointed hat and a flowing black dress riding a broomstick at Halloween. It occurs on October 31st, which in the old Celtic calendar was the last day of the year. It was then that all the witches and warlocks held their wicked revels. Satanists still believe that, and that might explain why, through her subconscious, Kim Paris has given herself to the devil. It is the next morning. Sarah Paris opens the door of the farmhouse.
Oh, Lucy.
Good morning, Mrs. Paris.
Come in, Lucy.
I want to see Kim.
I don't think you should.
Why not? because she might turn her evil eye on me. I can understand that Stan's engagement to me shocked and hurt Kim, but she's an educated woman, not an old hag who invokes a curse against him and me.
Lucy, I found it hard to believe, too. Until she said that Stan would never marry you. Then when Father Francis questioned her, Kim avoided the subject. But she did say that God was not the only force in the world. Last night, I told her to leave.
Move out? Leave Perryville? You? Your dairy farm would rapidly decline, Mrs. Parris.
If it has been successful because Kim's allied herself with the devil, I say let the farm decline.
You surprise me. I'm not surprised about Father Francis. He's an alarmist.
That's disrespectful, Lucy.
The reason I drove over, Mrs. Parris, was to speak with Kim and dispel these suspicions about her. I expect Kim and you to attend my marriage. You'll see. Both of you will come to your senses and the priest will be discredited.
Is that what you want?
What we need in our parish is a young, modern priest, not an old man who sees evil in every shadow and is haunted by legends from the Middle Ages. Kim? Kim?
Hello, Lucy. How nice of you to stop by. How are you?
Just fine. The question is, how are you?
Fully recovered. I wish you happiness.
Thank you. And you do mean that, don't you?
I'll admit that I was startled and then angry. But that's behind me. When I thought about my reaction, I realized that there was no basis for it. If Stan had told me himself, but he didn't. I'm disappointed that he didn't tell me the news.
Father Francis has convinced him that you're a witch.
Oh, dear.
That's what I say, Kim. I chuckle inside when I think of you flying through the sky on a broomstick or stirring a cauldron filled with eye of newt and toe of frog,
wool of bat and tongue of dog. You remember your Macbeth.
Kim, tell me about Johnny Gilbert.
I can't explain it. What happened to me is that I had this bizarre dream or a nightmare.
And the tallow from the church candle cured Johnny?
Who knows?
I'm happy for the boy. But because of the cure, you've been marked as some kind of sorceress. Father Francis is doing. I'm trying to undo that, Kim. People get crazy sometimes. We don't want any harm to come to you.
It won't. I assure you, it won't.
I came as quickly as I could, Stanley. Is Lucy still alive?
Barely, Father. If Kim did this to her, I'll kill her.
Take me to her room. Where are Mr. and Mrs. Trumbull?
Well, he's arranging for a specialist to fly in from Boston by helicopter.
And his wife?
Well, under sedation. They were stunned. So was I.
Before we go in, tell me about it, Stan.
Well, Lucy called on Kim this morning. Lucy told me that they had a fine talk. No resentment. It was friendly. And then when Lucy returned home, she felt faint and her throat began to constrict. Mrs. Trumbull became alarmed, and so Dr. Routledge placed Lucy in the hospital.
Yes. What's his diagnosis?
The tests revealed nothing, but Lucy is having great difficulty breathing, like someone with severe asthma or something. She's under oxygen, but that hasn't helped much. It's as if some force had her by the throat. It's as if she's under a spell.
She is. I'm convinced of it. Let's go in.
All right.
Oh, poor child. Lucy.
Her eyes are open, Father.
Stan, I'm dying.
No. It's okay. You won't die.
Did Kim?
Yes. Kim did this to you. placed a curse on you.
A witch?
Yes. A woman possessed by the devil. He must be exorcised. Do not give in to this evil, Lucy.
I love you, Lucy. I love you.
Come, Stanley. We have a mission to carry out at once.
Where's Kim, Sarah?
Why, Dan and Father Francis, what's
the matter? Sarah, Kim has placed a curse on Lucy Trumbull, and she's dying.
Oh, merciful heaven.
Where is your daughter, Sarah?
I don't know. She went out. I don't know where she went. She's wandering the fields, most likely.
We have to find her. She's a soul devoted to the devil. Only exorcism can save her.
Exorcism?
The devil has possessed her subconscious. Kim is his victim. Stay here, Sarah. We'll find her.
You all right, Father?
Weary, Stanley. Weary and distressed.
Yes.
We have to find her.
But where? We've scoured the fields. Come on, Father. Let's try the barn. Father, is possession psychological?
More than that. It goes back at least to 650 B.C., when a man asked the gods to free him from a tyrannical ghost who possessed his soul. And in 1614, Pope Paul V laid down a procedure in a rite entitled Rituale Romanum.
Look, Father, the barn door slightly open.
Stop. There she is, Stanley.
Oh, no. Look, writhing on the floor.
I'll handle this, Stanley. I am Father Francis Sims, a priest. Who are you?
Go away.
You have filled this young woman with evil because you are evil. Who are you?
A fallen angel.
Who with selfish pride wanted to be like unto God.
We hate him. Go away.
This is a crucifix. Exorciso te immundi spiritus. I exorcise thee, thou unclean spirit.
No, no, take that away from me.
And this is holy water, and with it...
No, no!
She's all contorted.
And this is a rosary that I place in your hands. Why did you take possession of this innocent young woman?
Satan ordered me to, and I have obeyed him.
Why did he select Kim Paris?
She has always been alone and rejected, an outcast. She belongs to us.
I cast thee out, most unclean spirit. I cast thee out as a servant of God. Ixi ab ea, reaper. I hold superior power. I take her hand, and in it I place the sign of the cross. Leave.
Oh, my God.
She's collapsed, Father.
Yes. Carry her into the house, Stanley.
Is she all right?
I don't know. We've wrestled for her soul. I hope we've won.
Oh, Father.
No. Kim's pact with the forces of evil have been broken.
My daughter possessed of the devil.
We have to be as vigilant about our souls as we are about our freedoms. Kim has been alone for years. Ever since she came home from Boston, she has been a recluse. She brooded. That kind of introverted mind is where the devil sows his seeds.
Father, in this day and age, I can't believe it. I really can't.
We have witnessed it. Stay with her, Sarah. If she awakens, calm her. Make no accusations. I have to return to the hospital.
Oh, my dearest Kim, how could this have happened to you? Your hatred led you to invoke the terrible power of an evil, revenging fiend.
Mother?
Oh, yes, my dear.
Oh, what happened to me? Why am I here? You told me to leave.
You've been very ill.
Ill?
It's all right, Kim. Rest.
Lucy?
I feel as if a weight had been lifted from my chest and my throat is beginning to relax. What happened to me?
Kim happened to you, Lucy. Father Francis exorcised her.
He exorcised her?
I know that you thought I was being an alarmist, Lucy.
Father Francis became convinced that Kim was possessed, that she had made a pact with the devil.
I simply won't believe that.
It's true, Lucy. Less than 2 hours ago, you were dying. Kim's exorcism drove the devil's possession out of her, and the spell she cast on you was broken.
You believe that, Stan?
I do. I saw her change before my eyes from a mad woman to a crumpled, pitiful child. I carried her home, and we put her to bed. I'm so grateful you're better, Lucy. Forgive me, but I have to go back to Kim.
I see. Kim, she has possessed you, hasn't she?
Lucy, I can't turn away from her.
Of course.
I'll be here first thing in the morning.
I've lost him, Father.
Kim?
Stan?
How are you?
I don't know. Is Lucy all right? Mother told me she was dying.
She was, but Father Francis broke the spell.
Spell?
We won't talk about it. I'm sorry I hurt you so deeply, Kim.
Oh, that's behind us. I wish you both well. And if you invite Mother and me, we'll happily attend your wedding.
It can't take place without you there.
What? I don't understand you, Stan.
You will, Kim. You will.
An unexpected ending, but a satisfactory one. We have done, then, with the witch and witchcraft. But let me remind you of this, even today. Whether you view it in terms of religion or psychology, belief in possession and exorcism remains undeniably powerful. The belief is buried deep inside us. History supports with facts what is more than legend. I will be back shortly. Bertrand Russell wrote, and I quote him, "To understand witchcraft, we must descend into the darkness and the deepest oceans of the mind. There we probe a bizarre and barbarous chapter in human history, and an examination that even now cannot be explained adequately by modern scholars. Belief in witchcraft led to agonizing deaths of an estimated 200,000 persons, mostly women. With that, I close. Our cast included Paul Hecht, Diane Kirkwood, Terry Keane, Court Benson, and Mary Negro. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown." And now, a preview of our next tale.
Joe, can I ask about this other road, the one to the left? Any reason for not taking that one?
Left fork, very dangerous, not safe.
How? Why?
Lead to place where evil spirits dwell, spirits of the dead. Bad, ugly spirits.
Well, we're not afraid of things like that, are we, Jimmy?
No, not really. No, Joe, we are not afraid.
You listen, Joe. Take other road.
This way, Clark.
Well, hold on a bit, Jimmy. We didn't come thousands of miles all the way out here just to look for the Safeways. We came for the adventure, the excitement, remember?
Well, I guess so. Sure, of course.
Then let's not play it safe. We take the chance.
This is Tammy Grimes inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.